Hey, what's up? This is your boy Renegade Rand here again with the last podcast of the whole series. It's Basketball 101. This one is called WTH, or in short, what the hell? Because what we're trying to do, I'm discussing just what in the hell is going on, giving you a 2020 year in review. So check it out if you like the podcast. Look at it either on Anchor or on Spotify. Spotify, you search under Basketball 101, you'll be able to find me there. Hopefully, you know, this should close out the series. So, you know, hopefully we'll have basketball back real soon, you know, due to this coronavirus and the pandemic that's going on. But I want to make sure that you guys get everything you can out of learning the game of basketball and maybe bringing it back. I don't know. So we'll see what happens. Again, like and subscribe. And listen, you guys have been great. Take care and stay safe.
The coronavirus pandemic is hitting farmers hard. Some dairy farmers are being forced to dump their milk instead of selling it because there's little demand with restaurants and schools closed. Other farmers are struggling to harvest their crops, which could affect what you'll see at the grocery store. Foreign labor, mostly migrant workers, filled more than a quarter million jobs in the U.S. last year. As Mark Strassman reports, harvest season is here, but there are not enough workers.
You're looking at one of Georgia's biggest farms, 7,000 acres, more than a dozen crops that help feed America. In this cabbage field, we found farmer Bill Brim walking with his worries.
This coronavirus has got everybody so stirred up.
Does it keep you up at night?
Oh, yeah. I sleep about 2.5-3 hours a night.
Seasonal foreign labor, mainly from Mexico, always harvest Brim's crops. But this spring, he could be 200 workers short. The coronavirus crisis has delayed the U.S. government's processing of their work visas.
Bill Brim's facing a series of harvest deadlines. First one is April 15th, and these fields of squash. May 1st, it's cucumbers and so on. And he'd better have his pickers in place.
When we start harvesting squash, we've got just days to pick it. So if our workers don't show up here on time, then we're going to be in real trouble.
It's not one of those things in life where you can say, I'll get to it next week.
No. No, sir. I wished we could.
70 miles away, Jeremy White is in bigger trouble. His blueberry crop is days away from harvest. He needs 100 pickers and packers. But they're stuck in Guatemala, where the borders are sealed because of the virus. Nobody in, nobody out.
We need them now. Absolutely, we need them now. As you can see, this fruit's turning blue and it's not waiting on anybody.
More than $1 million worth of blueberries could rot in the fields. He has no plan B.
Domestic labor just don't want to do this kind of work. It's unfortunate to say, but I mean, they just don't want to get out and do hard field labor anymore.
Gary Black is Georgia's Commissioner of Agriculture.
It is a reality. If there are not workers, there'll be crops that will go unharvested. And that has a ripple effect throughout this economy, and it will affect the consumers of this nation.
Bill Brim's worries go beyond his labor shortage. What if the workers he does have get sick? And restaurants usually buy 60% of his crops. Not this year, not with so many restaurants closed.
This big farm, how much money could it lose if this doesn't turn around?
It could devastate us. It could put us out of business, really.
35 years you've owned it.
Right.
And this could be it.
That's right. Could be it. Hope not. We hope and pray not, you know. We're hoping this coronavirus will get out of here and we can go back to just a little bit of normalcy.
Timing is now everything here. These crops can't wait. For CBS This Morning, Mark Strassman, Tifton, Georgia.